my channel. Welcome to another video. Today I'm here and I'm been thinking. I have 71 subscribers. I'm having a problem of uploading at the time. That's why I take so long to upload. But I appreciate all of you that is on my channel. I appreciate you all. Bear with me. Don't stop watching and don't stop introducing people to my channel, because everything takes time and I'm trying my best to do videos in a timely manner, but most time I am busy, so I can't do it in as effective as I wanted to do. As I used to post every day, and so on, but now it is kind of hard to do because of that, my time frame. But I'm going to try to do videos even 3 times or 2 times per week. Anyway, I was thinking, and I'm saying this, sometimes only thing can fail you is fear. And when you are fearing anything, let your fear lower than your faith higher than your fears, because sometimes when you fear, like you feel like, oh yes, this not working out for me, and I don't know what to do, the best thing for you to do is ask God for guidance, ask for direction. Me, for example, when I'm down and out, I ask God for direction, give me courage, give me faith, give me guidance. So whenever you're failing, feel like you're failing, just say no, like a poet, like you have a plan, right? And because you have doubt in you, you don't go forward. Once upon a time, I was like not really stressed. I remember when I had my children, I was like very young. My kids born very fast, and they have, I was very young at the time when I had my kids, in my 20s, you know, when I have my kids. And I wanted to settle down, and I wanted to grow my kids with my children father. But eventually we could not take tea. Up to this day we cannot take tea. Sometimes some people that say, oh, she bad lucky. No, she's not bad lucky. You're not bad lucky, you are blessed and highly favored from God. Because sometimes the plan that God has for us, the plan that is God has for us, is more supreme than what we thought. We may say, oh, these things happened to me and I could not. When I was growing up, I wanted to become a model and a fashion designer. That was my goal. I also was an athlete. I love food. Those times when I'm growing up and I have all my plans, I had my plan, I wanted to be a model. I wanted to do fashion designing. I also wanted to become an executive chef. I've started the process because I went to heart and I did agro-processing in about 1998. That time I did agro-processing in Art Trust, and then I applied to Runaway Bay Art Economy to become an executive chef. Eventually, I had my first daughter. I did not go. I even applied for a school in Pennsylvania, and they accept my application at the time, but I could not go because I did not have financial stability to pursue. I did not have the help that I need at the time. Financial help is what I wanted. I did not have it, and my parents could not afford it. But a lot of people don't know these things. A lot of my family don't know these things. I've always wanted to become something. I've always had my mind on skill, educationally, financial too. You know, but sometimes when you move too fast, success slow or drift from you. Because when you're moving too fast, eventually you have not gained the understanding or the wisdom what you need. But things happen, and sometimes I don't let it deter me or let me feel like, oh, I'm going to stress over it. And I'm going to feel like I can't go on. I have continued life. I end up with my children. And I press through life and I struggle through life with my kids and my children. They grow up. The youngest one is not that young, but my kids, I have faith in myself, and I have courage within myself, and I have love within myself, and love for other people, because kindness is me. I'm very kind, and I'm miserable too, but I'm kind and miserable, and I'm very intelligent, but things that I wanted in life, I did not get it, because of the lack of sustainability that is required. But I do not let it deter me. So I'm telling someone today that whatever plans you have, sometimes the plan that God has for you is bigger than what you thought. Because all these plans that I have, because I have a plan to heal my family, but eventually it did not turn out. I end up as some children. But that does not deter me, you know, from go forward in life and seek sustainability for myself. It's not an easy road, but if you lost courage, you will end up fail. But sometimes only thing fail is risk. You've got to take risk. Life is about risk. Life is short, so you got to take risk along with faith. Faith and fear does not match. When the fear come upon you, what you need to do is let your fear go, your faith go more larger and higher than your fear. Let the courage be courageous. Be courageous and persuasive and persistent, and you will succeed in life. Don't let nothing deter you from achieving your goals, achieving what you want, you know. Because God sometimes is the author, is the finisher of all of our souls. So, this video is to encourage someone. It's just a little slight story I'm telling, just to encourage someone that is feeling down and out at this time. But don't feel away, just have some faith, have some courage, lift your head up high, because man is failure though, man is failure, so don't let discouragement make you don't persuade. Only thing help hinder you is yourself. Only thing hinder you is yourself that is afraid of taking a risk and taking a step, you know. You have to take the step, the leap of faith. You've got to have some leap of faith within you so that you can achieve your goal. Because the plan is there and the help is there. But in order for you to get it, you have to let fear go. You have to let fear go and let faith take over. But faith without works is also dead. Because if you have the faith, place is dark, but if you have faith and you just lie down in your bed and say, I have my faith, I'm on a way using my faith. No, you got to put your hands and feet and heart to work. That's how faith work, right? That's how faith work. You have to put your mind, heart, eyes and soul within it, and then you will succeed. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, share, subscribe. I'm begging you all to subscribe and share my videos with your friends and family. That's the only thing I'm asking, is to help me to reach 100 subscribers by Christmas, or 1,000. I would like that for my Christmas gift. Thank you for watching.